couple of weeks ago, we visited Shaughnessy Hospital to tell a story about the research center they're planning to develop here. And while we were here on that visit, we visited the spinal cord injury unit at Shaughnessy, a unit where medical research and treatment are way ahead. Well, they're pioneering in a lot of fields in that area in medicine throughout Canada. During our visit to the unit, we met a young fellow by the name of Neil Squire. Remarkable guy, young fellow from Nanaimo, British Columbia. A bit of background to why Neil Squire is here in Shaughnessy Hospital. Well, about 20 months ago, Neil got up one evening to go down to the store and get a quart of milk for his mother. Driving, he hit a bit of black ice and had a motor vehicle accident and suffered some pretty serious injuries. He came here. Now, even 5 years ago, the kind of injuries that Neil suffered would probably be fatal. But because of the advanced kind of treatment they've got at Shaughnessy, Neil is alive. The big challenge now, with a young guy full of ambition, full of energy, intelligent, like Neil Squire, how do you keep him interested in life? How do you provide purpose and meaning? And how do you give him the opportunity to make a contribution to his own life and to the people around him? How do you satisfy Neil Squire's dreams? Well, it is a remarkable story, and I'd like you to come inside Shaughnessy Hospital, upstairs, to the spinal cord injury unit, and meet Neil, because it's a remarkable story that I think you'll be heartened to hear. Let's go and see him.
Neil, how old are you?
I am 22 years old.
And I know you're from the hub city of Nanaimo.
That's true.
Civic pride in there somewhere. How long have you been in this unit at Shaughnessy?
Just over 20 months.
What kind of progress have you made from when you arrived to now?
Well, I'd say a fantastic amount.
To the point that you're plotting a career for yourself, aren't you? I mean, you're looking at a business future.
Yeah, that's right.
What are you thinking of?
Well, possibly accounting. It's not going to be phys ed.
But you could make phys ed programs through the...
Well, I could, I guess.
Neil, how extensive is your paralysis?
Well, basically it's from my neck. At first, when I was hurt, I could breathe on my own, but there was some swelling of the spinal cord, so my capacity to breathe and to speak fully was knocked out after, I guess it was a day or so.
One of the things I find remarkable about you is your optimism. And of course, you're a pioneer with this kind of a system as well. What gave you the first idea? What got you started on it?
Well, basically, it wasn't even my idea. In intensive care at the time. And my cousin, Bill Cameron, he thought of a way for me to communicate to other people.
At this point, you couldn't vocalize.
You couldn't move anything.
Well, I could talk to people, but since it was just a faint whisper, it was very hard for people to understand. So my cousin thought of an idea whereby using Morse code and blowing the Morse code through a straw, I could punch out some letters onto a small screen, and then people could understand me better.
Neil and his cousin Bill Cameron call this method of keying the computer the sip and puff technique. Those are Neil's actions. This is one of the keys to Neil's development toward independence. Another, still under design by Bill Cameron, will be a little robot to do the very few things that Neil cannot do with his computer. For example, the robot will be able to exchange disks and actually plug the machine in, turn it on and off. Neil, I know the perfect subject to get you on the record about, which is basketball, right? Why don't you tell me who you think the best basketball team in history is?